On June 15, South Korea will carry out the second launch of its first space rocket developed using domestic technology. Unlike the first try back in October, the payload will be real satellites. Han Seong-woo provides a glimpse of what to expect.
The date is set. On June 15, South Korea's first fully homegrown space rocket, Nuri, will lift off for the second time. 8 months after its initial launch came short of putting a dummy satellite into orbit. This time, though, it'll be attached with actual satellites, a 180-kilogram performance verification satellite and 4 mini cube satellites that weigh about a kilogram each.
But in second launch, now we have to verify that this launch vehicle can carry satellite which act like the normal satellite, and this satellite will verify the launch vehicle, the second launch vehicle, Nuri, is capable of delivering satellites into the space.
Nuri will soar into the sky from the Naro Space Center in the southern coastal village of Gohung, Jeollanam-do Province, in the afternoon, likely sometime between 3 and 5 p.m. The Science Ministry and Korea Aerospace Research Institute have reserved June 16th to the 23rd as the rocket's launch window in consideration of variables like bad weather. Currently being assembled and readied for launch, the three-stage rocket weighs 200 tons and measures 47.2 meters in length.
Launch vehicle is all parts and all assemblies, all manufacturings happened inside Korea. So it's a fully Koreanized launch vehicle.
Engineers have reportedly upgraded its third stage, which burned out earlier than expected in October, despite Nuri reaching its target altitude of 700 kilometers. According to officials, a comprehensive interagency drill was conducted last week to prepare for a wide range of emergency situations, including fuel leakages and unapproved drone disruptions. South Korea has invested more than $1.5 billion into the Nuri project since 2010. Han Seong-woo, Arirang News.